Hey everyone, welcome to the Globe Guys, and today we're much closer to home, aren't we?
We are, we're in, basically in our local area.
Yep. So we live, obviously, as you know, in Manchester, in the United Kingdom, and we live right on the very edge of Manchester. We've come just literally over the border to the county of Derbyshire and to the site of an old railway track that used to connect Manchester with Sheffield over the Pennines in South Yorkshire. Now, this closed in the mid-1980s, and it's now part of the Trans-Pennine Trail. And it was the first railway line, did you know, in the UK to be electrified.
Oh, really?
It is, yeah. And there's a really, really long tunnel. And I think at the time, I think it might have been the longest tunnel in the UK, which is about halfway in that direction, about 7 miles. So we're going to head down there. We've hired some bikes, and it would only cost about 13 quid
to
hire the bikes.
Yeah, it was expensive, to be fair. It's a perfect day. I mean, it's a glorious day, you know, there's no wind at all. It's just, it's perfect for riding a bike.
Just put a bit of context as well. This week, the UK has gone into lockdown again. For the second time, so there's not much else to do. All the pubs are shut, all the shops are shut, the gym is shut, so we're doing this just to get out of the house and also get a bit of exercise as well.
Absolutely.
So we've got the bikes, we're gonna get going. So we're just under a mile away from Hadfield. We've got Manchester in that direction, Sheffield in that direction, and we're starting to head up into the Pennines now. You can see the reservoir there, and those reservoirs will just go one by one. There's continuous reservoirs all the way over to where we're going to go, to where the tunnels are, and they feed Manchester with the water that it needs. What are you doing there, Ivan?
So, setting up the drone. So we are gonna fly our DJI Mavic. All right, and see if we can get some good shots of the reservoir in this beautiful area, because it's pretty cool. Been going probably about half hour, give or take, now, and I'm surprised how flat it was. I mean, this is an old railway track, and it literally it's just flat, so it's perfect for riding a bike. I mean, it's great, you know what I mean? There is no energy needs to be exerted at all. So, but you know, when you're going along, you've got lots of woodland and stuff, and then you get really nice little picturesque little views like this, which is really good. But my stomach's growling, so we need food. And there's lots of bloody bugs flying around everywhere, which will do me head in. And when you're actually riding a bike, I'm constantly like this. You know, the landing on my face and everything is doing me head in.
So as we say, this is part of the old Woodhead railway line, which ran between the two major cities of Northern England, Sheffield and Manchester. And you can tell there's lots of reminders that it used to be a railway, so we're on a railway bridge at the moment. So this is actually the old railway between Sheffield and Manchester, as I mentioned. But much of the Trans-Pennine route, which stretches from Liverpool to Hull, is built on former railway lines. And some people actually do the full bike ride from coast to coast, from Liverpool to Hull. We're not doing that today, which is fine by me, because my backside's aching already. and yeah, it's not the softest of saddles, and Ivan's getting hungry, so we need to try and find somewhere now where we can sit down and have something to eat. So Ivan's happy now, we found somewhere to stop and have dinner. We had the foresight to stop off in Tesco just before we left Hadfield.
We did, all the supermarkets are available.
So I've got hoisin duck, it's a wrap, got no mayonnaise on it. I wanted mayonnaise, so I don't know why I picked that.
Oh,
man,
it'd be fine, it'd be nice that. Did you swap?
No, it's fine. Okay. It's a bit squash, but it'll do.
And I've got some chicken, tomato and basil pasta, yum, so.
And then for after, we've got cocoa, vanilla, flapjack. And to make sure we don't get tired on the ride back to Hadfield, sugar-free Red Bull.
Normally I'd have had probably about 3 coffees by now, but because we had to rush out because we did this kind of last minute, I didn't have time, so.
And you're not going to find a Starbucks around
here. I'm not going to find a Starbucks around here anyway, so yeah.
So I reckon we've got about, I don't know, maybe about another 20 minutes till we get to the Woodhead Tunnels. Once we get there.
I don't know what to expect here, you know.
Well, it's just tunnels. You'll know where it is, but because where the tunnels are, it's right underneath the road, so you'll never see it from the road.
Will it be big?
Yeah, huge, yeah. There's actually 2 sets of tunnels. So there's 2 of the tunnels that were built back in the Victorian times, and then you've got the brand new tunnel, which I think is still one of the newest tunnels on the UK in the UK.
Oh, really?
And it was built, I think, in 1954.
Well,
yeah. If you're wondering, I know somebody's going to make a comment, where are your helmets? Well, it's pretty flat. We're not on the roads, so we decided not to wear helmets in the end. We did plan to initially, which is why I've not done my hair.
But you don't have to wear helmets, yeah. So it's fine.
Yeah, but yeah, if you are interested in these kind of things like old railway lines and old buildings and stuff like that, Ivan's got a friend and he's got a YouTube channel called, is it Martin Zero?
Martin Zero, yeah.
Yeah, and he does lots of things like this. So if you're interested in that kind of thing, because we don't do too many of these videos, we're mainly about travel. But if you are interested in that kind of subject, then why not take a look on our website, on his website either, or his YouTube channel, I should say. Yeah.
Martin Zero.
Yeah, all things Manchester.
Oh yeah.
And whilst we're plugging other people's YouTube channels, why not subscribe to ours? If you're watching us on Facebook, our YouTube channel is The Globe Guys.
It is, so give us a like there. We also have a website, www.theglobeguys.com.
Check it out.
Yeah, there we go.
So we've made it about 90 minutes after leaving Hadfield, we've made it to the Woodhead Tunnels, and I'm actually stood on the platform of the old Woodhead station. We've got the tunnels there, we're going to show you them in a minute. You've got the new tunnel and the old tunnels as well. And then above you've got the road which leads between Barnsley and Manchester. So it's the first time, even though I've been on that road many times, this is the first time I've been down here. So it's great, so we're going to have a look at the tunnels. So if I was stood here less than 40 years ago, I'd run the risk of being knocked down by a train as it sped through the tunnel towards Manchester. But it got closed down in the 80s, which is a bit of a travesty really, because there needs to be a fast railway line between Manchester and Sheffield. So this is the new tunnel, and I was right, 1954, says up there, look. And that is the Victorian tunnel. So I think they closed these years and years and years before because they were flooding, and they were built for steam engines. And when this one was built, it was built for the electric trains. I'm outing myself as a little bit of a train geek now, aren't I? but yeah, so I think the tracks were lifted in about 1986, something like that. Can't remember, not sure. But yeah, it's mad. It is mad to think, because I think it is actually the newest tunnel in the UK, not including the Channel Tunnel, obviously. There's not been many tunnels, certainly, that's been built since then.
So instead of railway lines running through here, it's now electricity lines because it's owned by the National Grid.
So that's the end of the video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Have you enjoyed the bike ride?
I have, no, it's been great. It's been a great day. You know, it's very flat, it's been a, you know, there's no wind. It's been great for bike riding, you know, and sun's starting to set now. We need to get motoring, but it's starting to go a bit cold. That's why I put my hat on, you know. But no, yeah. It's been great.
It's fair to say that Ivan and I are probably more city boys than anything else.
True.
But we are lucky that we live on the edge of a big city. And because of that, we've got the city on one side of us, and we've got this right on our doorstep as well. So it's really, really good. We are really lucky.
We are.
And it's been years since I've actually owned a bike, so it's great that you can actually hire a bike near to where we live, and we can take the advantage of this trail. If you are visiting the area and if you want to hire a bike, then we'll leave some details on the screen about where you can hire the bike from and where we hired ours from. Also, if you're coming to Hadfield on the train, you can actually get the train from central Manchester to Hadfield on what's pretty much the only part of the Woodhead Line that's left, and they run about every 30 minutes between Manchester and Hadfield and Glossop.
They do?
Yeah.
But, you know, for someone who's not a train geek, because somebody is a train geek, right, and I'm not in the slightest. He still is a train geek.
I'm not a train spotter, honest. Yeah, I'm not a train spotter.
Well, I find it really interesting, actually. There's been a million times, right, that we've driven over there, which is the top up there, because Ryan's family live over the other side. So we drove that a lot. And I had no idea whatsoever that this was here at all, right? And I think it's amazing. I love it. I think it's quite interesting. It's been a really great Saturday afternoon for me.
It has, yeah. One of the reasons why we're doing this, I guess, was to get out of the house, because we are in lockdown. And we've not been travelling quite as much this year, but we do still have a lot more videos to share with you, including our very recent trip to Italy. We've still got some videos from that trip coming your way, and we've also got some videos as well from our trip right at the beginning of the year, which was right at the start of the old COVID nightmare. So stay tuned, because we do still have lots of videos coming your way, even though we've not been travelling as much as what we perhaps
usually do.
If you are watching us on YouTube, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and if you hit the bell button as well, what happens?
You will get notifications when we drop new videos, and that's really important, because I assume you want to watch them, because that's why you're subscribing in the first place.
Yeah.
So let us tell you about them.
Make sure you do subscribe. If you are watching us elsewhere, maybe on Facebook or elsewhere, then please do head to our YouTube channel. It's called The Globeguys.
Where
you can view all of our videos, and you can also view all of our videos on our website as well.
You can. www.theglobeguys.com.
And do you want to plug the digital business?
Yeah, we're both digital business owners. We help people set up their own digital business where you don't need to do any selling and you need no experience. If you want to find out more about that, drop us a message, because we want to help you. We've now more than ever, sorry, now more than ever, more and more people are working online. We need to work online because we can't work anywhere else. So drop us a message, find out more.
Right, we'd better get off now because we've got about an hour until it gets dark, and I reckon it's going to be about an hour and 10 minutes before we get back to Hadfield.
Hour and 10 minutes so. on a saddle that is getting more and more uncomfortable.
You'll feel it tomorrow.
I know, but hey, what the hell.
Anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video, wherever that may be.
See you later, guys.
Bye.